Reading from the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 14, text 18. Urdvam gachanti sattvastha madhye tishthani rajasaha jaghanya guna vrittistha ado gachanti tamasaha. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Those situated in the mode of goodness gradually go upward to the higher planets. Those in the mode of passion live on the earthly planets, and those in the abominable mode of ignorance go down to the hellish worlds. So, I'm not sure, did we do this yesterday? I think we did. So, reading the next one, let's continue. Text 19, Nanyam gunebhya kartaram yada drashtanu pashyati gunebhyascha paramveti madbhavam do so adigachati. When one properly sees that in all activities, no other performer is at work than these modes of nature, and he knows the Supreme Lord, who is transcendental to all these modes, he attains my spiritual nature. So one can transcend all the activities of the modes of material nature simply by understanding them properly, by learning from the proper souls. So same, if we want to know about some knowledge, we want to get an education degree in finance, then we go to a university which is renowned for its finance. We study under good professors, and then we become proficient in the knowledge of finance. So same, if we want to have knowledge, spiritual knowledge, then we have to go to the proper authority, to the pure devotees, because they have the knowledge, they have the spiritual knowledge. We can't just make up, we can't just think, oh, I'm going to try to become a spiritual a devotee by myself. Same way as we will not become expert in the field of finance just by making it ourselves. We are going to a proper authority to learn. So same way, for spiritual knowledge, we go to the proper authority. The real spiritual master is Krishna, and he is imparting this spiritual knowledge to Arjuna. Similarly, it is from those who are fully in Krishna consciousness that one has to learn this science of activities in terms of the modes of nature. So Krishna, he's the origin. He's the one who spoke the Vedas into the heart of Brahmaji. And then he's also the one who's giving the spiritual knowledge to Arjuna. So Krishna is the supreme authority. And then the devotees who are Krishna conscious, they know the science of Krishna. So they know the science of spirituality. They know, they have the proper knowledge of soul, of matter, of Krishna. Otherwise, one's life will be misdirected. So if we don't learn from a proper authority and we keep acting under the instructions of somebody who is not proficient in spiritual knowledge, then we are not going to go to the proper destination. We will not reach the spiritual world. By the instruction of a bona fide spiritual master, a living entity can know of his spiritual position, his material body, his senses, how he is entrapped, and how he is under the spell of the modes, material modes of nature. So how right now we are hearing from a bona fide spiritual master. Srila Prabhupada is a bona fide spiritual master coming in the disciplic succession in the Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. And he's teaching us. We are learning his teachings by reading the Bhagavad Gita as it is. We are understanding, oh, what is my spiritual position? I'm an eternal part and parcel of Krishna. And I'm not this body. I have these eyes and the ears and nose, but that is not me. I am trapped inside this body. And then how under these modes of goodness, passion, and ignorance, how I'm being just like a puppeteer, like this, I'm just dancing like a puppet in the hands of the modes of nature. He is helpless being in the grip of these modes. But when he can see his real position, then he can attain to the transcendental platform, having the scope for spiritual life. Actually, the living entity is not the performer of different activities. He's forced to act because he's situated in a particular type of body, conducted by some particular mode of material nature. So we might think, oh, but what's happening? But let's try to analyze. We, the soul, right now, because I'm in this body of a human being, I'm acting as a human being. I'm walking on two legs, using my hands. But me, the same soul, when I'm in the body of a dog, then I walk on four legs and I bark, I don't speak. How is it possible? It's the same soul, it's the same me. How can it act so differently? It's because the body is under different modes of nature. To explain this, we have the story of Lord Indra. Lord Indra is a demigod, he's the king of heaven. He was cursed somehow, and then he came in the body of a pig. And so in the body of a pig, he thought he was a pig. He was walking on four legs. He was living in the sewer with his pig wives and pig children. He was not sitting on a throne and thinking, I'm Indra. No, but it was the same Lord Indra. Unless Lord Brahma told him, what are you doing? And pulled him out of the body of the pig. And then Lord Indra said, oh my God, what was I doing? You know, so same here, we are changing our bodies. And then whatever the modes of nature the body is under, we are forced to act in that way. Unless one has the help of a spiritual authority, he cannot understand in what position he is actually situated. With the association of a bona fide spiritual master, he can see his real position. And by such an understanding, he can become fixed in full Krishna consciousness. So it is so important to take guidance from a bona fide spiritual master, not a so-called spiritual master. The spiritual master should be proficient in the knowledge, in the science of Krishna. Only then can he help us cut our ignorance to the root. Sorry. A man in Krishna consciousness is not controlled by the spell of material modes of nature. Why can he help? Because the spiritual master, he himself, because he's a pure devotee of Krishna, he's above the modes. Even though he's in the body, he's above the body. He's liberated. The example is given of a coconut. You see, there is some coconut that if you shake, because the coconut has been separated from the shell, you can hear it. You know, it's separated. You can hear the noise. But there are some coconut which are too connected to the shell. So the liberated soul is like that. He's inside the coconut. He's inside the shell, but he's separated. He's not identifying himself with the body. So the liberated soul, I'm sorry, or the pure devotee, spiritual master, he's like that. And he knows the truth. A man in Krishna consciousness is not controlled by the spell of the material modes of nature. It has already been stated in the 7th chapter that one who has surrendered to Krishna is relieved from the activities of material nature. For one who is able to see things as they are, the influence of material nature gradually ceases. It's because Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 7th chapter, he says that you just surrender unto me. You know, and then this material, it's very easy to cross beyond this material ocean, which it comprises of this material modes. It's very difficult to give up these modes, but when we become devotee of Krishna, then we rise above the modes. And so that's why it is always recommended for us to hear and chant. Chant the Hare Krishna mantra, hear from Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. Regularly in the association of devotees. Any questions or comments? If no, then we can stop here. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Shla Prabhupada ki jai, Gaura Bhakta Vrinda ki jai, Gaura Premnande, Hari Hari Bol. Thank you for joining. And...